Hello, good morning students. So this is what your next chapter after vector algebra. So line and plane. So before start a line and plane, so let us recall about what is meant by straight line here. So what we studied in our, which was studied in our 11th class, and this is what the 12th class NCERT mathematics syllabus takes, a line and a plane here. Yes, so now here, so what we know about straight line? So basically straight line is what? It is the locus of the points, means it is the simple form of the locus where the locus are satisfied one condition, it is called the slope takes. Mean the slope between any two consecutive points on this line, it is always equal. Okay, and what we know, that we know the different forms of the straight lines. So different forms of the straight line, we have the general form of straight line, ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So this is what the general form. Yes, the general form of the straight line. We have another form of straight line, it is x y minus y1 equal to b m into x minus x1. So this is what the point slope form. Point slope form it is. Yes, we have another definition, it is y minus y2 y minus y1 equal to be y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into bracket x minus x1 it is. So this is what the two point form. Yes, we have another definition, which is y equal to be mx plus c meet intercept form. Intercept form it is. Yes, we have another form it is. What is that? X by a plus y by b is equal to 1. So this is a double intercept form. Double intercept form we have, and also we have x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equal to b. Means it is a normal form of the statement. Normal form of statement. Yes. So these all the definitions, these all straight lines which are defined in the two dimensional geometry. So means here, whenever you take a straight line, to define a straight line, we need at least one point. At least one point means at least two points. Yes. In the case of what? We have the two dimensional geometry. And here we have the 12th mathematics in the 12th chapter, line and plane. The line and plane, this line is basically derived from here only, but it is in the three dimension, and what we study in before, it is the two dimensional geometry. Yes, and we are going to be studying in the line with the same thing, but in the different way. They are providing the different types of the equations for the straight lines, and which are in the form of three dimensional part. Yes, and basically to define a line in a three dimension, we needed direction ratios and direction cosines. So that was a known also in the vector chapter, what are the direction ratios and what are the direction cosines. Okay, so let us begin with let us start with the definition. We know the different forms of this straight lines. Let us start with the chapter number 9. Yes, so note down, if you are unable to understand, if you are not known about these all forms, please note down that. Yes, so let us start with the line chapter. Yes, note down this.